wheels spin and wheels spin. You got no money and you got no home. Spinning wheels all alone. Talking about your troubles and you never learn. Ride a painted pony, let the spinning wheel turn. Did you find the directing sign on the straight and narrow highway? Would you mind the reflecting sign? Just let it shine within your mind and show you the colors that are real.
Sergey, first of all, we saw your computers being taken away. What were the police looking for on your computers?
I'm afraid I won't be able to answer this question. I simply can't.
Okay, now, from what you know, did they find anything? Obviously, they were trying to use your expertise. You're here as a computer expert, if you like. They were using your expertise to help them analyse Robert Murat's computers. Did they find anything that helped them with that from looking at your computer?
I wouldn't know. I haven't been told, and I don't know. Simply, I don't know.
Was there, just gauging from the police, was there a suspicion that you were hiding something, or there was some kind of encryption involving computers that you were hiding something for Robert Murat?
As well, again, I wouldn't know. Simply, I don't know.
Just give us a sense, if you can, of why you offered your services, you offered to help with the police investigation. Why do you think the police thought that you could help?
Well, I guess from the previous interview I gave, it's because of my computer skills. And then whatever they might find out from my interview. So we'll see.
Just give us a sense, if you will, of your role. You are something of a computer expert, am I right?
Yes, correct.
So how do you help people?
I fix their computers, if I have to. Servers, any kind of assistance with the computers.
And how did you get to know Robert Murat, and what sort of assistance did you give him?
I can't comment on that.
But did he approach you? From what we can gather, you helped set up his website.
My relationship with Robert Murat is strictly professional.
Give us a sense, if you can. We know that Robert Murat was interviewed as a suspect. Other people have been interviewed as witnesses. We heard today you were interviewed as a witness, but the police suggested that in the course of the investigation, that could lead to you being interviewed as a suspect. What do you understand from that?
I guess police know better. Well, who's the suspect and who's the witness?
Just take us through yesterday, if you will. What happened? We know that you spent around 2 hours in your apartment with the police. Take us through the whole day. Tell us the story of the day.
I wouldn't want to say the preliminaries and minor things. It's just, I've been taken by police. I got out from there late night. I got home, slept, and went there today again. And now I'm going home, and they confirmed that I'm a witness, not a suspect. So basically, I'm just going to wait for further investigation to see what's going on.
Now, you've been talking to me before we started this interview about your feelings about speculation, particularly in the Portuguese press. I mean, just what particularly do you want to set the record straight on?
Well, first of all, I'm not 30 years old. Second, I don't rape little kids. I'm a normal man. I don't do any swinging stuff. Third, my criminal record has been clean, always. I'm a resident of this country, so they would check that before they would give me a card. And I simply feel hurt by media, the way they describe me as a tyrann, as something unhuman. And they, without knowing, without asking, they assume things. The false information has been placed in the journals, on the TV. And it's damaged my name, not damaged harm, I would say, and my career. And those responsible to it will be held to answer.
We know that Luge is a very small resort, really, and you've lived there for about 5 years. Did you ever come across the McCanns or Madeline? Did you ever see her?
Never, ever, no. The first time I've heard of Madeline was the day of, not the day, I think the following day of the tragedy.
There again has been speculation that there are records suggesting that you and Robert Murat had phone conversations around the time that Madeline went missing. Did you speak to Robert Murat around that time?
I cannot comment on that as well, I'm sorry.
What is your relationship with Robert Murat?
My relationship with Robert Murat is strictly professional, as I quoted before.
So, just going back to these allegations of sexual offences that the Portuguese media in particular seem to be pursuing, what's your response to that?
I simply would ask media to leave me alone. I want to get on with my life. I have a career to run, hopefully, and I want to clear my name. So, all those responsible for a false information and incorrect information will be held responsible to it, and we will try to arrange something.
Have you ever been in trouble with the police in any way in the past?
Never. So that's the first time, and it's gone really bad. bad in the way of media, of course.
Have you gained any sense from the police that they are going to continue? I mean, how much of their equipment, of your equipment rather, do they still have, and are they going to continue to analyse that?
They will going to continue to analyse. As the first part of a question, I can't answer that.
And from what you can gather, I mean, the suggestion that I think it was a general suggestion that being a witness can lead to being a suspect. Have you gained any sense from the police that you will be anything other than a witness?
No, I don't really know. It's the police. They know better what they're doing, and they know all the leads to investigation. So whatever they think is right is right.
Do you know anything at all about the disappearance of Madeleine McCann?
No, I know. And if I would, I would share it with everybody.
And have you had any contact with Robert Murat in these past few days? We know he's been lying low in his apartment. You have a professional relationship. Have you had any contact
no,
at
no.
all?
No, he never contacted me. I never contacted him, no.
And from what you know, I mean, how is he dealing with this?
To be honest, I have no idea.
So from here, what will happen for you? What do you intend to do to carry on setting the record straight, as you put it?
Like I said before, I would like to clear my name. I would like to get the record straight with the media that's been presenting false and incorrect information by holding them responsible to the information and proving them wrong with the facts.
Hey, for this.